Thank you very much, Mr. Iden.
Let's go, guy.
We'll keep in touch.
Let's go. I'll take this straight to the airport.
You'll be rushing to catch the 2 o'clock flight.
I'll make it.
It's Sunday morning on CBS, and here again is Charles Osgood.
Linda Hunt won the Oscar for Best Supporting Actress for her role as a man in the 1982 film The Year of Living Dangerously. These days, she's pursuing her craft on the set of a popular TV series, which is where Lee Cowan found her for this Sunday profile.
She's hard to see on set sometimes.
Miss Linda, you ready?
Yeah.
Lost amid the chaos of a busy day of shooting.
And action.
But once the camera finds Linda Hunt, she nearly always steals the scene.
I need to be with Michelle.
I promise you that we will do everything we can to protect her.
She plays Hetty Lang, the diminutive cloak and dagger boss who's in charge of the undercover federal agents of NCIS Los Angeles.
There's no fuzziness, Gallon. You still shoot the ducks. I just row the boat.
At 67 and just 4 feet 9 inches tall,
what about Dallas?
Hunt spends her days surrounded by actors who are half her age and almost twice her height.
Don't mock me.
I criticize, I scold, I chastise. I've even toured someone a new one, but I never mock.
So what's it like being on set with a group of young,
I know,
very good-looking slash rock star?
They're all so young.
Do you like that?
I do like it. I get a kick out of it.
And that younger set gets a kick out of her, too. In fact, Hunt has taken home the Teen Choice Award for Best Actress in an Action Series the last 2 years in a row.
So this is my hangout.
That's your office?
Yeah, this is my office, Hetty's office.
Her stage is a massive two-story set at Paramount Studios, where attention is paid to every prop, no matter how small.
This is a plastic cow with a lot of correct anatomical things.
Her sense of humor makes for a playful atmosphere backstage.
It's over your shoulder.
Standing on the outside, looking in. Always.
Story of your life, right?
Yes, it is.
There's even good-natured teasing, especially over the one thing that she has and her co-stars don't.
And the winner is Linda Hunt.
An Academy Award.
This is extraordinary. They tease me about having won the Oscar.
What is there to tease about winning an Oscar?
Well, you know that I'm the only one who has it, and would I bring it to work? And, you know.
That's great, old man. That's what I've always wanted, a real partnership.
It was this performance that won her that Oscar back in 1984, in the Year of Living Dangerously.
I made you see things. I made you feel something about what you write. I gave you my trust. So did Jill. I created you.
Hunt plays Billy Kwan, a male photojournalist who's hired by a rookie foreign correspondent in Indonesia, played by a very young Mel Gibson. It was only Hunt's second film, but it was a first in movie history. Never before had an actor won an Oscar for playing the opposite sex. She was so convincing as a man, audiences didn't believe the credits.
I can't be a man, but I can embrace the head of a man, the intelligence of a man, the spirit of a man.
Did you ever feel you'd get lost in him, that character?
Yeah, yeah. And it was like that for a while. I'd come back to my beautiful room, and a guy would bring me dinner and refer to me as sir.
As sir?
It was upsetting, and it was weird not to be able to turn it off, not to be able to come home at night and just be Linda.
Her transformation not only won the Oscar, but it was a relief to Hunt's parents, who always worried about her life on the stage, especially her father.
I think up until I won that night, he always worried. It was proof from people he didn't know, from a world he didn't know, that, you know, his baby girl was going to be all right.
His baby girl was born Lydia Susanna Hunter in 1945. She grew up in Westport, Connecticut, and was always smaller than most.
Everybody either wanted to take care of me or push me around. You know?
Were you teased a lot?
Yes, I was teased a lot. Sure I was. I knew that I was different by the time I was like 10. Everybody was taking their spurts, except me. I was not growing up.
She was diagnosed with a form of dwarfism. Nothing could make her taller. But when her parents took her to her first Broadway show, Hunt realized the stage just might be a place where she could at least feel taller.
It was a production of Peter Pan that...
Absolutely.
And what was it about Peter Pan that really struck you?
That it was bigger than life. And that in some sense I longed to be bigger than life. Because I wasn't.
She compensated with her voice, trying to sound more authoritative than she looked.
When I was 16, nobody else talked like me. Nobody else sounded like me.
There was a confidence in that.
Oh, absolutely.
That made you big.
That made me big.
That voice first found a home on stage, and then the silver screen.
Don't you dare!
What do you think we're fighting about?
Strong, independent characters suited Hunt the best. From Gertrude Stein's Lover in Waiting for the Moon.
Suppose I keep guessing and you tell me when I get warm.
Suppose you try figuring it out instead of picking apart everything I said.
You work here?
I run the place. What can I get you?
To a spark plug of a bartender in the Western Silverado.
Are you the Midnight Star herself?
I am. I'm always there, but I only shine at night.
Can I help you?
But it was a comedy that introduced Hunt to a whole new generation of fans.
What did it feel like to hit that son of a bitch?
When she played opposite her physical opposite, Arnold Schwarzenegger.
It felt great.
In Kindergarten Cop.
What's that like, being opposite Arnold Schwarzenegger?
Oh, for me? Are you kidding? I, you know, maybe if I'm lucky, come up to his navel.
Bella, come here. Come here.
Seeing her on stage or in person, you soon forget her stature. Just ask Karen Klein, who says Hunt's size was hardly the first thing she noticed.
I was kind of struck.
And so, what were you struck by, honey?
Linda's corduroys.
Her corduroys?
I don't know, something about the corduroys.
Those corduroys were the beginning of a 26-year relationship. They were married in 2008.
Karen's 6 years younger, but I forgive her daily. I wake up in the morning, I do, and I forgive you for being younger.
They are as open about their relationship as Hunt is about her future. NCIS Los Angeles may still be going strong, but she says she doesn't want her role to last forever.
You know, I will retire one of these days, Mr. Gallen, and when I do, I don't want to be thinking about you alone.
I look forward to a time when I don't have to work anymore.
Do you?
Which is, I do. I really do, which is close at hand.
Miss Linda.
Yeah.
Her current contract will take her into her 70s. Not bad for a woman whose own parents feared might be too small to stand out on stage. But Linda Hunt still has audiences looking up.
What do you think your parents would think now?
They'd be so happy that I'm earning a check every week. A paycheck every week. They would be thrilled.